Gary Gilmour, his second over of the day to Amos. Well bowled, and that's out. What a good delivery. The in-swinger, and umpire Constance satisfied. Amos on the back foot, it was going to hit the left stump.
Fantastic start here. Really has looked the better of the two bowlers. Swung that ball in late, he's moved a few away. And that's a brilliant catch, a beautiful catch by Marsh, taking it almost out of Ian Chappell's hands. I doubt very much whether Ian Chappell will be very pleased about it, but relieved that Marshy managed to stick hold of it. So all three have fallen to Gilmour. The outswinger moving away there. Greg falling for the trap. And he's out. The third wicket's down at 26. And Tony Gregg's out for 7. Pitch to get him away, but nicely clipped through mid on, took advantage of it. It's racing down the hill for 4 runs. So just about the first loose ball from Gilmour there.
That's a sad way to go. A fourth wicket for Gary Gilmour. What a spell this man is having. Gary Gilmour, he has the remarkable figures of 4 for 10.
Hooks, he's clearing pickets, and the Chappell's eyes have got that killer gleam. Mr. Walker's playing havoc with the bats. Red Park, it's good to see you back. Lady's making runs, Dougie's chewing gum, and Gilmour's wielding willow like hacks.
Through and he's out. Keith Fletcher, LBW. Fifth wicket for Gary Gilmour. Left arm over the wicket, this ball ducking into him. Well, no sooner had I said it than another big swinger from outside the off stump.
Pretty late on that. This is a magnificent spell of bowling by Gilmour. Alan Davidson would have been proud to put in a spell like this. And he's out, another one gone. Alan Knott out for naught. 35 for 6, and Gilmour's sixth wicket for 10 runs in a quite dramatic opening spell.